Hollywood.com.
It's a Simpsons invasion here in Los Angeles, where the Quickie Mart has taken over a local 7-Eleven. We'll be in Homer Heaven as we fill up on donuts, Duff beer, and squishies before heading over to Westwood for the much-anticipated film, The Simpsons Movie. Now let's go check in with Bart and the crew on the red carpet. Longest-running TV show in history finally makes its big-screen debut. Hi, everyone. I'm Carlene Davis of Hollywood.com, and we're at the much-anticipated premiere of The Simpsons Movie. Now let's go catch up with all your favorite stars who you've grown to love over the past two decades.
This is C. Montgomery Burns, and you're watching Hollywood.com. Now stop it and get back to work.
Well, I do, Homer.
Krusty the Clown.
Grandpa! Grandpa Simpson, that is.
Barney Gumbo.
Sideshow Mel. Oh, there's your Mayor Quimby. And then there's
Hans Mole Man. There's Gil, the salesman. You gotta buy from Gil because the wolf's at old Gil's door.
There's a teenager who works at the Krusty Burger.
I am Agnes Skinner. And I'm Brandine, married to Cletus. I'm Cookie Kwan. I sell real estate on the west side.
Millhouse. Jimbo, man, that is so gay, Millhouse.
Happy God, the little Flanders boy.
Now, I'm told you do the most voices out of anybody.
I don't know if that's true, but I do a lot.
All right, tell us who you do in the movie and TV.
Burn Smithers, Principal Skinner, Ned Flanders, Reverend Lovejoy, Kent Brockman, Otto, Lenny, Scratchy, McBain. But there are a few that I left out.
And your favorite?
C. Montgomery Burns.
Now, you created the series, correct?
Three of us, Sam, Simon, Matt Groening, and myself. And Matt created the characters. He drew the characters.
Now, where did the idea come from?
For Matt, Matt came over. We were starting a variety show on the Fox Network when that was a brand new network and hardly had anything on. Matt had an appointment with me because I wanted him to work on the show. And in 10 minutes, waiting, he drew what became The Simpsons.
It's been one hell of a ride. It's been fantastic. The writers just, for 18 years, to come up with new stories and satire and in the moment, it's just been, and keeping the integrity of the initial project alive is just, it's been overwhelmingly great.
It's the only entertainment show I know of on network television that doesn't get subjected to creative interference by the network executive. That's just a special part of The Simpsons way of doing things, and I think it's allowed the show to be what the creative staff wants it to be as opposed to what eight geniuses in suits think it should be.
Real people who have made the characters on The Simpsons come to life. Reporting from The Simpsons premiere in Westwood, California, I'm Carlene Davis with Hollywood.com. Can you say you're watching Hollywood.com in Homer?
You're watching Hollywood.com in Homer.